I was living with Mike Grella. I met him there, lived with him. But then again, here we go. Oh, David Salma. We've got Jermaine Beckford, Luciano Becchio. You can't just replace him until they get injured. So they never got injured. They scored like 1,000 goals between them. You got to go on loan. No problem. Nothing's going to like break me now. Let me just go on loan. So I go to Chesterfield, tear my hamstring. Come back. Go to, I think the next one was, yeah, Lincoln. After Chesterfield was Lincoln. And that's where my whole life changed as a soccer player. They were in that battle for regulations, you know, relegation. So brought back memories from when I was in Italy, had a good little team. Chris Sutton was the coach. He played with Alan Shearer back in the day. They called him the SOS. I learned everything from this guy. This guy used to take me after training 2 hours. We'd train for 2 hours. I'd stay with him 2 hours. Teach me runs. Teach me how to stay behind on the shoulder of the defender, you know. So many things. Scored 9 goals, I think, in 12 games. Kept them up. Our last game was Bury. Scored, I guess, 1-0, 2-0. I forget what it was. Kept them up. But that last game, I don't know if it was the red card. My last game at Lincoln, we were winning or something happened. And now Leeds at the same time, Jermaine Beckford has scored a crazy goal for them to get promoted now. Because I never played League One. While we were in League One, I was training with them. I went on loan to League Two. Now, they just won the title. We're playing at the exact same time. So anyway, we got saved. I ended up headbutting a guy because he spat on my face on the corner kick. So I'm driving back. They getting promoted. I'm suspended 3 games. You know, it was crazy. The whole emotions was nuts. So come back that following season because now I had signed. Lincoln wanted me. A whole bunch of clubs, you know, were really interested in because once you score goals like that in Europe, your name is out there. Like you, compared to like a defender, it would take you a couple of years to get somewhere, you know, and really sustain yourself at. But as a striker, you score in six months, you can go to like big clubs. So next season, that's when, you know, I'd signed that professional contract, and that was good times. You know, that was like, okay, been through everything. I would do it all again to get to this time in my life because I enjoyed it, man. We played Liverpool in the FA Cup, played Chelsea. We got to play Tottenham. Gareth Bale played against him. You know, I mean, I coming from literally nowhere, and I'm, you know, played at one of the best clubs in the world. It was crazy, you know. It's crazy how it happens.
Obviously, when Leeds got promoted, that was the highest level you could play at, but you were just on fire at Lincoln. Yes, you got sent off in the last game, but was there ever a thought to maybe I'll stay here? I mean,
yes, but that transition was tough, man, because I had Chris Sutton telling me, you know, I really want you, but I know you're not going to stay. You know, he's basically telling me that. He's like, you belong to Leeds. They're getting promoted. They'd be stupid not to. But if they don't, you know, we're always going to be your option to come back to. And I had other, you know, Chesterfield even wanted me. I only played like a game for them. But yeah, definitely that transition was hard because it's like, you know, you grow with a coach that really, I never used to take free kicks. The guy used to make me take free kicks like curlers. I'm not about that. You know, like he made me the point man of everything, and I felt like I had like a responsibility. You know, I was never captain. I don't even think maybe one game, but the responsibility that he gave me was just crazy. So, yeah, at that time, but you know, right away, you know, Leeds picked me up, and that was it. You know,